Alright, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the channel. Today, we're going to be talking about Jabari Smith Jr. and a little bit more about yesterday. If you guys enjoy, hit the like button, hit that sub button. We are trying to hit 2,500 subscribers now. Appreciate all the love and appreciate everyone tuning into last night's live stream. I had a lot of fun watching the Rockets Magic. I know, judging from comments, judging from Twitter, just on my show today, a lot of other Rocket fans don't feel the same way, but for the most part, I think we got enough of we got enough to be excited about. You know, Tari Eason, Ty, Jabari Smith Jr., they're all going to pan out. They're all going to pan out just fine. It looks like we have a nice little backup point guard who's ready to play at the NBA level immediately in Ty Washington. I can't believe that man slipped all the way down to 29th. I know it's early, but I can't believe that happened. Tari Eason looks like defensively he's going to be a stud, and offensively he's got, you know, he's a little raw, but so are all these kids. So Jabari, lastly, our number third pick. I want to say this real quick because I noticed this in OKC streams, but I really noticed this watching Joe Polo. Shout out Joe Polo. I really noticed this watching his halftime live stream about the Pistons. Everyone was calling, or not everyone, I saw some people calling Jaden Ivey a bust already. And it gets me thinking, Jabari, last night in my live stream, there were so many people just calling Jabari a bust. You can't predict Banchero, Chet, Jabari. It doesn't matter who it is. It's too early to decide if it's a if they're a bust or not. Jabari dropped 10 points, 7 rebounds, 3 assists. He had a nice little three-pointer. But it was very clear, you know, he's a very raw player. Banchero came out. He was ready to go. He wanted to guard Jabari. That's exactly what happened. He kind of almost had, like, a chip on his shoulder because he got drafted number one, and it was like, all right, let me show you why I got drafted number one. He was definitely ready to play. Jabari started really slow. I'm sure nerves were, I mean, keep in mind, man, this is a big level. You know, this is something that these guys have been waiting on for their whole lives. And don't put too much stock into it. I mean, Trae Young shot like 12% from three-pointer in summer league. Trae Young coming out of the summer league, people were labeling him a bust already early on. And look at Trae now. He's balling out, and he's one of the best point guards in the league, one of the best young players in the league. Jabari definitely has things he's going to work on. They're going to have to develop this system. Silas is going to have to develop a system where Jabari is being set up, not only, but just a system that works for him, system that works for Jalen, a system that works for their whole offense. And it's going to be interesting to see how the Rockets' offense looks at the start of the season, midway through the season, end of the season. I would say Silas's job is on the line this upcoming year. I trust the process. I trust Silas. I don't think he's a bad coach. I just don't think we have a good roster. We haven't had a good playoff caliber roster, so we're not going to make the playoffs. It's pretty simple. Silas, at the same time, did come in to coach Christian Wood and mainly James Harden. So the Rockets are in a weird spot where we went from making consecutive playoffs, like 9 straight, was it, to having one of the best players in the league, to being the worst record, and then getting Jalen Green. Now we got Jabari. So we're back on the right track. We're 100% back on the right track. And I think Jabari's progression is going to be interesting. I think he just needs to simply be more aggressive. And that was something that he acknowledged in his post-game press, was, I just need to be more aggressive. And it's tough in summer league because it's not Silas the coach, FYI. The coaches aren't really that critical in summer league. Like, they're not really even drawing up most plays, or drawing up any plays, I should say. You're looking at rotations, you know, who fits well with who. A lot of the Rockets game last night was very boring to watch because it was essentially just drive and kick. You'd have one of our guards drive and then kick it out, or not a guard. It could have been Tari. It could have been anybody. Anthony Lamb was big last night on just driving and kicking out. So there wasn't much offense going on. There's no setup. There's no schemes. There's no plays. There was barely any pick and rolls last night from Houston's standpoint. It was mainly just, like, pass the ball, everyone standing by the three-point line. So Jabari came out and said, like, I forget what it was. Jackson Gatlin asked him a question. He was like, I got to be in the right spot. You know, I got to be in the right spot on the defensive end, got to be in the right spot on the offensive end to help clear the glass, like get the offensive rebound. There's just a lot of stuff that Jabari's going to learn, like where to be when, what to do when. There's just a lot of stuff that's going to go into this, but you really just need playing time. So that's why I view, you know, I know Jabari wants us to make the playoffs and he wants to get us to the playoffs, but I have a feeling that he will start pretty slow. However, we're just talking one game. You know, I don't want to get too far ahead of myself because I don't think Jabari played bad in the slightest. The first half, the first quarter didn't really go his way. Things weren't going great, but once they started getting him going in the offense a little bit more, he started to drive a little bit. He started to finish. He finished with his left hand on numerous occasions, which was nice, finishing over players. So you had that. You had a three-pointer, and then you had, you know, the bad stuff where, you know, the travel call was tough when he had a wide-open three. And then also, one thing I noticed, but this was with most of the Rocket players, I think this just was because they were playing so small, is let's say Jabari was guarding somebody on the wing and one of their guards drives in. What I noticed last night is almost all the Rocket players, whoever's on that help side, usually comes in to help. So they get down in the paint, force the double team, maybe even force the triple team, depending who else is down there. And then the Magic guard, RJ Hampton, or whoever it would be, Caleb Houston, they would kick it out to a three-point shooter. Bang, shot goes in. I noticed that quite a few times. I noticed that several times with Jabari, but then I also noticed that with guys like Tari. I noticed that with almost every player on the team, just providing help down low in the paint when they get down there. It's like the Raptors last year in the playoffs, just because they're so small. They don't have the size. They need more bodies down there. So I think that might have just been the game plan straight up. I just think that most of the shots that I saw that went in, it just so happened to be Jabari guarding him on the closeout. So, you know, maybe keep an eye on that for next game. How's the closeout defense looking? How's the transition going to go? How's the three-point shooting? How comfortable does he look? I would just say he didn't look comfortable. Paolo Banchero looked fully comfortable. He looked like he deserved to be the number one pick, as he did. And Jabari was just a little bit more on the raw side, a little bit more, I don't want to say nervous or anxious, but just a little bit more, the handle was definitely loose. It was all over the place, led to some almost turnovers, I should say. And yeah, these are things that'll work themselves out, man. We got three more games. We're going to keep getting more film on Jabari. We're going to keep getting more film on the team. And I also would say, like, it's not like Christopher was really helping him out. Dacian Nix, Ty Washington, I think those two guys did a much better job distributing the basketball. Josh Christopher kind of took for the first three quarters, like, ball handler duties, and he was pretty much just setting himself up, which I don't have an issue with. I'm just saying it's kind of hard to get a good feel from these guys. Like, look to Jovic on the Miami Heat. His first game, he scored 5 points, or I think it was actually 3 points. He scored like 3 or 5 points on 1 of 5, 1 of 6, 1 of 7 shooting, something like that. And he never had the ball in his hands. It was very similar to Jabari last night. Anytime he got the ball, he would just force something up because he wasn't getting the ball. And, you know, you start to get upset. You start to get nervous, maybe, whatever the case may be. Jovic, just like Jabari last night, kind of started forcing up some silly shots in the first half. And ultimately, what did Jovic finish the summer league with? Like 25 or 27 in his final game. So, you know, this is just stuff that's taking time. And keep in mind, he's playing a center position. This is a position he doesn't play. Like, there's just so much that goes into this right now that it just doesn't matter. We'll see how Jabari looks on Saturday. I'll be live for it. So hit that like button, hit that sub button for daily Rockets content. But most importantly, go ahead, drop a comment down below. What did you guys think about Jabari Smith Jr.'s game last night? Peace.